Well, good evening. Welcome to Motocraft on Urban TV, and your presenter is Richard Chimba. Of course, we are doing the continuation from the last week's program, where we are looking at the lighting system and we are looking at the bulb. And of course, I'm still busy with bulbs since the other time. You know, there is a lot to do with bulbs. Sometimes people think bulbs are just a very small kind of stuff. This stuff, I believe, is familiar to you from the last week's program. But there are things that we did not look at last week, which we want to look at now, and then we wind up the show. First and foremost, we have to look at bulb replacement. Apart from the technicality of replacement of the bulb, it's very important for everyone to understand that when you're replacing the bulb, you need to do a certain considerations, like considerations of the specification of the bulb. The first specification will be, of course, the wattage of the bulb. And the wattage determines what we call the light intensity or the light illumination from the bulb. Of course, the higher the wattage, the clearer the bulb. And of course, the lower the wattage, the lower the illumination. But the manufacturer, definitely when they are making bulbs for a particular type of vehicle, they definitely consider the wattage or the power that the bulb is supposed to illuminate. So when you're replacing a bulb, it's very important for you to look at the technical, scientific and electronic specifications of the bulb. And every bulb must have that information inscribed or written on the bulb. For example, this particular one is made from German, and it is 12 volts direct current, and it is between 100 and 90 watts illumination. And of course, when you put this bulb in power, for example, if it is in the night, you may not be able to sustain looking at this bulb in a short range. Apart from you knowing the specifications of the bulb, it's very important for you to know why, in most cases, you have the bulbs, maybe the right specification of the bulb, but you don't have adequate light illumination in the night. Had many people complain, for example, when it comes to the night and they switch on their lights, they are not able to see properly, and so that has become so rampant on many cars. One of the things that you should know is that once you have the lights fitted in the vehicle, especially the whole light, the whole unit, it's not just fitting the light and, you know, screwing it on. It's also about what we call a beam alignment. These lights, when the vehicles are released from the workshop, they are released when they are preset to have the beams illuminate a particular area. For example, when you have a low beam will have to illuminate on the sides of the car as well as on the extreme front of the car, about 10 to 20 meters. You should be able to see what's happening in front of the car. And when it comes to the high beam is able to send a signal and concentrate it in a distance which is about 30 meters plus, so that when you're driving at a very high speed and you need to reduce, you have appropriate reaction time that takes place for you to be able to respond in time, especially when you need to brake. So with time, because of sometimes the maintenance that goes on cars, sometimes we remove the lights and we put them back and we remove them out of alignment. So in most cases, when we are removing these lights, sometimes we don't even consider getting the alignment. So that's why we on some modern equipment, we have equipment which is responsible for light or headlight alignment, where you take the vehicle there and then you have your lights aligned. And by alignment, it means that the beams are set to be concentrating their light in a particular area according to the specifications of the manufacturer. So apart from the beam alignment, because of course when your lights are not showing properly in the night, one of the causes is misalignment in the beams. Secondly, you have got wear of the light assembly. In terms of wear, I mean, for example, most of the modern lights today are made out of transparent plastic, and with time the plastic fades on top. And once the plastic fades, the effect of the reflector inside the light is not effective, because it is going through a faded plastic glass. And so that one definitely affects the concentration of the illumination out of the car. And if it is not the faded plastic, it is the faded reflector. And you know, the reflectors fade many times, just because sometimes water and dust find their way into the headlight. That's why it's very important that after you fitted your bulb in the vehicle, you have to make sure, in your light, you have to make sure that you even put a seal. This kind of seal is responsible for preventing dust and water from entering into the light assembly. Once light and dust enter into the light assembly, they're going to affect the reflector. And so with time, when that happens consistently, with the time you're going to find that your reflector is so much congested and clogged, and it does not give a clear illumination, especially in the night. So in most cases, what is done is the light is removed and disassembled, and then cleaned and then put back. This is something that is done locally. However, to some people, they prefer, you know, replacing the whole light assembly, of which I don't have a problem with. Secondly, when you are looking at the lights, you also need to make sure that the connection of the glass together with the rest of the light body, you know, it has some joint there, that joint is not loose. And also you need to inspect the light for cracks, because cracks allow in water, and also they allow in dust in entering into the light assembly. And once that happens, you have a problem that it is going to affect your light lighting system, and then you are not going to have the right illumination happening elsewhere on your vehicle. So it's very important for everyone to understand how these lights work, and so be able to prevent failure of your headlight in case it has to fail. The factors to consider, of course, the wattage of the bulb. You need to also consider the beam cleanliness. So once you have that beam cleanliness, then you'll not have a problem with the light intensity. Part of the other lights, of course, which we basically looked at before, but not in detail, are the other, you know, lights. The principle is the same when it comes to indicator lights, when it comes to parking lights, when it comes to reverse lights. The construction and the operation and also the care remains the same, because they are definitely all lights. And the same care you give to the headlights, the same care that you're supposed to give to the rest of the car lights that happen. The other issue is to make sure that all your lights, of course, apart from being clean, that they all light. Because if some of the lights don't light, then you have certain communication that's not given, especially when it comes to the night. Sometimes people, when you look at a car, for example, at the front, and you look at the light like this one, if you have this bulb, small bulb missing, for example, if you have this this small light missing and the other one missing, by missing I mean when it's not working properly, then you have a problem that the width of the car will not be determined, especially when it comes to periods when somebody has to drive the vehicle in the night. So the same care you take when you are looking at the headlamps is the same care you should take to the rest of the lights, including, of course, the wattage the wattage as well as the quality of the bulbs that you have to replace.